heading to Wyoming. I'm on my way to pick up Al right now. ETA to his place is about 20 minutes. And then we're gonna pack up the rest of the truck, get his gear in the truck, and hit the road. It's gonna take us approximately 20, 22 hours to get there. We're gonna drive the entire way. At least that's the plan for now. We'll take turns driving as needed, but we're hoping to get in there tomorrow, late morning, early afternoon, something like that. The weather for the weekend in Wyoming is actually looking really, really warm. It's gonna be in the 70s, but Monday, there's like a 30 degree drop in temperature. Monday could be a very, very good day for us, but we'll see. It's rifle season. I have my 6.5 Al, I think he has a 308 or something like that, but we'll get into more of his gear when we get there. And I wanted to do a quick gear video before I left, but I just didn't have time. So I might do a gear rundown as we're out there setting up camp and getting ready for the big show. But super pumped up. Never been this far west in my life other than Wisconsin, but I don't even know if you count that, coming from Michigan. So going to Wyoming, super pumped to hunt something different, new terrain. Weather looks awesome for the whole week, really. It's going to be in the mid to upper 40s or low 50s the entire week. With the type of hunting we're doing, that sounds beautiful. Cannot wait. Go get Al. Get Al in the truck. Get rolling. See you soon. All right. Just met Al. We're loaded for all the meat and all the adventure. But I have something for you.
Ooh, thank you.
Not many people have that.
Nice. I feel included in the club now.
It's exclusive.
All right, I just got to go over my checklist here.
Okay. Let it rip.
Maps? Did you get your maps downloaded?
I downloaded some, yeah. I did that the other night. All that scratching you're doing, sounds like you got everything.
Almost. Just about everything that I got here, I got in the truck.
So the truck's good?
Truck's good. Truck's real good.
Truck's got fresh oil in it, too. All right, you heard him. Truck's good. The next stop is the gas station, and then Wyoming. All right, classic gas station shot time.
Perfect.
How much is gas?
$4.29.
That's not so bad. Actually, it's pretty bad.
Pretty bad, yeah.
Considering it could have been $2.29.
Yeah. This is still public.
Yes. Hey, we're hunting.
I know.
We're hunting.
15 hours later.
Yeah. What's today? October 21st? Right? Just got out of the truck, threw all of our stuff on, ran into a guy, gave us some information, and now here we are trying to find some animals. Vast wilderness that we have.
I think they're on their way.
The animals are on their way.
You gave them a copy of the script earlier this morning.
Yeah.
So they know where they got to be and when they got to be there. So we just got to get to our spot and meet them.
I like it. Let's do that. Yeah. All right, let's go do that. Oh no, he's an old guy.
Is he?
Got like white hair. This is the second guy I got on film peeing in front of me before.
Really?
Yeah, back in the thumb, turkey hunting, dude stopped on Purdy Road. He's just driving, opens the door like this, pees, closes the door, gets back in. Man, I'm an idiot. You gotta do that again.
You not recorded again?
I wasn't. How you feeling, Al?
Feeling real good.
Yeah, you feeling dangerous?
Yeah, feeling dangerous about tomorrow, yeah.
Alright, I'm feeling dangerous too. We got a good spot over there.
Yeah, that's good.
So, we'll see what we can do in the morning. So we just had our first action of mule deer. We had a, it looked like a doe and maybe three fawns, or a doe and a couple fawns and another yearling doe come by. We hiked in about almost a mile to this spot, and then we noticed that we were surrounded by other hunters, so we just sat on this slope here. You can probably see Al behind me. He was glassing that direction, I was glassing this direction, because there's a nice point here where these kind of like drainages all come together. And then the same with Al's spot, he's got a nice flat on top of this peak, and then it drops down into this valley. And that's exactly what those mule deer did, so it was pretty cool to see. And I had one in the scope just for fun, to see. It's our second day, so I'm not really too keen on shooting a doe just yet, but you ask me in a few days, it might change real quick. But it was really cool to finally see some mule deer get within well close enough the entire time. They were less than 200 yards, even on the top of the mountain peak on the other side of the valley, there was only 245, so well within range. And here they are, they just came back out. Sure enough, they went right down to that drainage that I was just telling you about. They got spooked. There's a truck on the road out there, a long ways away, but the truck stopped. I'm sure the deer saw them.
Ridge across this bottom from us, and hopped over and scooted along and walked out of our lives. No boys, but saw some, got saw on the some. Board. Better than getting skunked.
Happy to get on the board.
Yeah. Pretty exciting.
Kind of feels like you kind of know what you're doing.
Yeah. Yep. So yeah, it's a good morning after, seemed like the whole town was out here with us.
Six, four hunters, maybe six hunters.
We saw six over here, didn't we?
Yeah.
Six that were hiked in that had the same idea as us, is getting away from the other out here. Eight that were parked out by the road, kind of by where we were planning to go.
Oh yeah, the morning. Morning was poop.
Yep. But it's public land for you.
Yeah. So we hiked in and tried to get away, and we found more folks. But we found the deer. They didn't, though.
It's true.
It's a nice.
They didn't seem to be very patient. They were.
They hiking. Were moving and a shaking.
Yep. So.
Back to camp.
Back to camp. See if we can get on some antelope here this afternoon.
That'd be awesome. Be like turkey hunting for antelope this afternoon.
Yeah. Yep.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
He's a forky. He's a big forky. It's from here. Say hi, Al. It's day four here in Wyoming, and we're on this piece of public that we found a couple days ago, and it's looking really promising because we had a really good hunt this morning. Seen two mule deer bucks along with a group of does, and then we also saw a herd of an antelope that had at least two bucks in it. So everything is looking good for this spot, except when we got here today, there's three other people that tried to join the party with us down here. So luckily they went onto somebody else's property. We believe they're trespassing, but it doesn't really look like they cared. But they're doing them, so we'll let them do them. But it's Monday. I forget what day it is, but we got the wind in our face. It's about 40 degrees, maybe 38 degrees, and the sun is out after that snow this morning. And it's absolutely beautiful. We have a great view. There's a herd of about 100 elk a long ways away, but we can see them with our glasses. So there's a herd of elk that we can watch. We get some bugles every once in a while, which is really, really cool. Especially being from Michigan, you don't get this type of scenery. So we're going to hunker in here. And I told Al just a minute ago, I'm expecting movement by about 5:30, 6 o'clock. I'm going to say it's roughly 4:30 right now. So I'm feeling good.
we'll see something eventually here, because this spot has produced every time we sat in it, whether it was in the morning, the evening, we've seen antelope and mule deer at the same time. So we're hoping that trend continues tonight. So we'll see what we can do, but we're feeling good. Again, it's Monday, 4 days in. Got another rest of the week to figure this out, and we'll do our best. See what happens. Something at that four pointer with how close he was. That was really, really cool. But we're still holding that hole for this big one that's down here. We just gotta get him off of private land somehow and onto public, so that way we can get a shot at him. But a really cool morning so far. It's day five. It's Tuesday. It's right around 8 a.m. Wyoming time here. It's cold, but it is a good morning to be out. So we'll see if we can possibly knock one down here.
We can't get to that spot where we were set up for the antelope the other day.
Down in there?
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right. Drop down in this chute right here and just take it down, because then we'll be fully blocked. Let's keep an eye on our wind.
Yeah.
See if they should be well within 300 yards. There he's at. I think let's do that for starters. Get down to that little knob down there.
Which knob?
Not the big one over there. This one down here.
That one right over this face, right?
Yep.
I gotcha. Yep.
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 So yeah, let's drop down right here and side hill it. Or get down to the bottom rather, and then follow that bottom all the way.
Alright, we're making a stalk in a nice buck right now. He's bedded down. Not sure on distance yet. We gotta get a little bit closer. We left our glassing knob. Went all the way up top and dropped back down into a drainage. We've been belly crawling for the better part of 100 yards or so. Maybe not belly, but hands and knees crawling. The buck is currently, he's on the other side of this slope, a ways out, but he's looking towards the lake out here. He's looking that direction, so we got the wind in a good spot. So we're gonna keep easing our way up, try to get within range and see what we can do. He wasn't. So we thought he was over here, but he's further to our right yet. So we came back, got our packs. Gonna make approach from behind him because the wind's in our face. And right now he's about 467 yards to the top of the tree he's bedded by. So we gotta cut the distance at least in half. And I think we can do it. Let's go.
Looking this way.
Those does came out of that spine that was 400 exactly and walked straight to the left, and that's where they're at. So he's probably right at 400.
Is your camera going?
Yep.
You ready?
Come on him. Nice, hit, reload. Reload, miss.
Where'd it hit?
You hit him high and back.
All right, he's going down, baby.
He's down. Still alive, he's down.
He's not moving at all.
He is down.
We did it, bro.
We did it, man.
Nice shot. Incredible shot.
400 yards in the kill zone.
That's awesome.
Made the adjustment on the scope. Waiting for him to turn broadside. It's like Al Yano. Yep. Okay, here it goes. First shot. It was so cool. You could hear it. You could hear the gun.
Nice.
But then the deer had no reaction until his back legs went down and then he fell. And then I sent another one, but he was wheeling around on the ground pretty good. So I was just like, I don't know where the second one went, but he's not moving now. One shot. Two shots, one impact, which is all that matters. And he's down, baby! We've been hunting our tails off all day. We made a stock of crazy hundreds of yards on a deer that disappeared.
Day five.
Huh?
Day five.
We've been camping out up here, eating Mountain House and everything else you can think of. And now we get the reward of the pack out that's gonna be hell, but it's gonna be fun. Bro, nice. Way to go, dude.
Nice
I'm
shot.
So thankful. I'm so
you
thankful.
You did the work, man. You pulled the trigger.
Let's go see him. All he's right. Done. He is stiff as a board.
Alright, we'll check in when we get there.
There's a path there. You know, you get down in these trenches here, you feel pretty small.
stud. Oh my gosh. Look at that guy, man. Look at the character. So he's a 4x4 with two kickers down here. Two brow tines, if you want to call them that, I suppose. And then he's got something funky going on over here with just the two. Man, is he a heavy deer. Hoo-wee! What a stud muley. He stinks too. He stinks like a rutted up muley. But man, what an amazing adventure we've been on. Day 5. I don't know what to say. I'm speechless. We've seen this buck probably, I don't know, 3 times.
Oh, for sure.
I think at least 3. Sometimes it was over there. Most of the time he was over here. And he just happened to hop the fence today, and now he's coming back to Michigan with us. But using the Creedmoor 6.5 Creedmoor with the Trigicon AccuPoint. Oh my gosh. Looks like the exit came in top of the lungs. And that was it. That was all she wrote. But amazing animals. This country is impressive. Coming from Michigan where everything's flat, it is not flat out here. Not by a long shot, but glad we're doing it. Thanks to Al. So let her rip. So we did. Now we hopefully get some backstrap tonight, just a little bit. Does that sound good?
Sounds very good.
Sounds good. All right, well, we got a pronghorn tag left. I'm gonna be full-time cameraman after this one. And we got enough time to do it, so we gotta get on some pronghorns. Al's up next. You're in the kill zone.
What do we got going on here, Brown?
Well, we're done with the boning out process. Now it's the hauling out process that comes next. The next part is trying to get this heavy sucker up on my back. Oh. Yeah, that's heavy. Oh yeah.
Piece of cake?
Yeah, chocolate. Ask me when we go to the first hill.
Oh yeah, I will. It's right up there.
Thanks, man.
All right.